You boys. Hunter, there is to be no devices during the week. Do you understand? Do you understand? Do you understand? Yeah? And that's the rule. Got it? If there's an emergency, there's a home phone there. And if there's a real emergency, you can message us. If there's no emergency, you don't need to text me about silly things. To pick you up, to do this, to do that, to guitar lessons. I'm the adult here. I know when all your things are during the week. That's what adults do. I don't need you to organize me. Do you understand? And tell me where I am and ask me what I'm doing and how long my clients are going to be, all this and all that, and mind your own damn business and do what you were asked to do, which is, when you get home, do your jobs. Do you understand? All of you. Got it? Instead of being smart asses and back chatters and rude to my wife when she's here. Do you understand?
Yes, Mark.
Is this table and this kitchen floor a place for you to throw all your crap when you get home from school?
No.
Those of you who don't, I'm not talking to you. Do you understand?
Yes.
Because I'm sick and tired of either walking in myself or hearing about it when Therese walks in to this mess. Yeah? Brendan's got to do clothes straight away and fold them up on the table. How's he going to do that if you've all dumped all your school books and school bags and everything all over the table and just peeled off your clothes and peeled off your bags as you walk in the door? Is that acceptable, the words I'm using? You sure? Well, you're looking for words to say back at me. Because guess what? We talk. And we find out about all the little games and tricks that everybody plays.
You know the first thing that I did last night when I went to the shops, Hunter? Was walk straight into Big W to get those shirts for you. And then you come down this morning. These don't fit me and I can't wear them. Rudely.
Yep.
That wasn't kind, was it?
You were saying that this was rude all the time.
It was rude. What Mark just said goes for you especially. Stop dumping your bag and your crap all over the floor and tables.
Okay.
You get your lunch boxes out, you put them on the table, you take your bags upstairs. And if you have swimming stuff that is wet, you get it out of your bag and you put it in the wash box. And I'm looking at two people in particular who have swimming right now. Because I shouldn't have to be up till midnight trying to get stuff dried for the next day. Because you are too lazy to do what you need to do. And you can't even be kind about stuff. The back chatting that goes on from each and every one of you at this table right now is absolutely disgusting. Always trying to pick out something that we are saying that is wrong. You don't want us to talk to you like this and stop treating us like we're pieces of trash. We pay the bills in this house. We put the roof over all of your heads. If you don't like it, you have an alternative, don't you? We're not saying that we don't want any of you here, because we do want you here. But your behaviour is what we don't want.
Where do shoes go? Can we establish this?
On my feet.
Have you on your feet? Thank you, smart ass. Thank you. Thank you. Top form. 1 point for Robert. Have you taught your kids over the years to drop their shoes here?
No.
Have you taught them to drop them in the bathroom?
No.
Which is every single night they're in the bathroom.
No.
Have you taught them to put them in the hallway?
No.
Because Robert now has a routine of putting his shoes in the hallway. And he told me off last night because I put them back in his room. They're for morning time! I said, well, what if I put everybody's shoes in the hallway when we've got six kids? Where do shoes go, Robert? In the hallway where I can trip over them in the dark?
No.
I just want to establish that. Your shoes, I don't want to feel wrong.
Your shoes go in your bedroom, and you know that. Just because you have to get out of the room so your sister can get dressed doesn't mean that you can't pick up your bloody shoes and go and put them on the lounge outside your bedroom, does it?
Headphones, jewellery, makeup, cosmetics, all over the toilet, the system, the bathroom. What are the boys supposed to do with that? And then you can't find anything and you go off your nut if anybody touches anything. And yet nobody can go in the bathroom and use the toilet because the top of the toilet is covered with crap.
Don't look at me.
Yeah, look at me like you're confused. Argue with me, please. Bring it on.
It's your stuff.
The boys don't. Do you wear necklaces? You sure? Any of you guys wear necklaces or earrings or whatever the hell's all over the chains and whatever? No? It was all over the bathroom yesterday? No?
You have a habit of just taking stuff off and just leaving it everywhere, Nina.
She's confused.
Everywhere.
I don't have any clue what you're talking about.
Doesn't have a clue, darling.
The stuff that you left all after you shower, all over the bathroom yesterday. You do it all the time.
I didn't leave anything.
She didn't. She didn't. This guy's, we're crazy.
You
we,
did.
We need to be committed.
There was crap everywhere.
There's something wrong with me. I'm crazy, aren't I, Micah?
Don't look at me like that. You can actually flow with this conversation and say, I'm sorry.
Doesn't know how to.
I don't know what you're talking about. That's the thing.
Same when you walk into a room, darling, and the bomb's gone off. It wasn't her. She has split personalities. They just have to get in touch with one another and tell each other what all the personalities are doing. Didn't you think that was funny?
I have not even the slightest clue.
There's no
idea. Okay, I don't care about hearing. I don't have the slightest clue. You hear what the words that are coming out of our mouths, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Keep shit tidy.
Are we wrong with saying to you, pick up your crap?
No.
Great. That's what you're being told. You leave your stuff everywhere, and it doesn't matter what room I walk into, there's something of yours, at least one thing. Sometimes 10.
Here, kitchen, bathroom, stair,
everywhere.
I've been doing it since.
True or no?
Doing it since I met you, Pina. I could follow you around the house and tell you exactly what you've done for the day.
So, instead of leaving your stuff everywhere, when you're finished, pick it up, take it with you. That's what we are saying. You don't want to get in trouble, don't make the mess. That goes for everybody. Because what's the one thing that we always walk into? We have busy days at the salon. In pain and whatever. Do you think we want to be coming home and cleaning up after all of you? What do you think on Wednesday I went off my face about the mess? There was literally shit from the door all the way through to the kitchen. But nobody owns up to it. I didn't have it. Wasn't me. I washed up the bowl that I had. But here's me standing there washing up everything else. If there's anything in the sink, will anybody else wash it up?
No.
No. Not at all. But you all expect us to be, do, and have whatever you want, whenever you want. Am I correct? We're tired of it. We shouldn't need to keep saying the same things a billion times. But it is literally the same conversation every single day.
For 5 years.
Every single day, it's the same conversation. True?
Mm-hmm.
I go up to your bedroom pretty much every single night, pick up this, do that, and I sit up there for a half an hour or more. And yes, I'm looking at you two, not looking at everybody else, not talking to anybody else in that situation. You two. You two are far from being babies. You're 16, you're 14.
That's enough stirring, drink it.
Move that glass, Robert, before you knock it off the table.
Mm-hmm.
All we want is for you all to do your jobs and keep it tidy. We're not saying it has to be immaculate.
Can't imagine that.
Because you kids wouldn't understand what that would be. Not a thing out of place. Everything put back in its actual spot that it belongs. Clothes folded and actually put away neatly. You know, every time that you're a smartass, you're not being a smartass to us. You know who you're being a smartass to? Correct. So do you think Yahusha likes your behaviours?
No.
That's it, all of you.
The jobs you are told to do of an afternoon take you about 5 minutes. Well, they would take me 5 minutes, possibly 10. 10 minutes. To whip some clothes off the line and fold them up. 10 minutes to whack some sandwiches together. 10 minutes, not 10 minutes to make dinner, but it doesn't take long to do the jobs you do and to have this floor tidy and this room clean when we walk home, when we get home. And then you can go upstairs, go in the pool, do whatever you want. Simple. Simple. Were you there when I told Teresa I actually walk in further towards the bikes along this side to see if the water's moving in the pool? I get so excited if I see the water moving in the pool. You know why?
Because it means we're in it.
Means it's being used.
I go on it every day.
Well, good, mate. I get excited if I see a slight wave on the pool. That means at least someone's been in it. But every day, normally, guess what it looks like?
Still.
Still. I walk in and go, oh, okay. Everybody's upstairs. Doing something. They shouldn't be. Have you ever had a swimming pool in your house since you were born?
No.
No.
I'm glad I can remember.
This is the first house since I've been married with children since I left my parents, and this is the first house that I've ever been in that has a pool in the backyard. Yes, you've probably been in 100 houses, haven't you, Robert, with pools in them?
No, yeah. He has not.
Prince Ali, yeah. So,
never.
Are you sure? We can agree on that point?
Never, ever had a pool.
Yeah.
It's killing you to agree with me, isn't it? Look at him. You can't get the words out.
I had none that I could remember.
And I just told you, you've never ever had a pool. Until we moved in with Nan.
Because you know, if you were in the pool, maybe I'd get home and join you. You got a huge pool there.
That was one thing that everybody said in Atherton. We want a pool, we want a pool, we want a pool, we want a pool. And since we've had the pool, who goes in it?
The novelty's worn off. You better enjoy it because you've only got a few more weeks left before it starts to get cold. And you won't want to use it.
What are you doing, Robert?
Do you understand what we're saying? We want peace in this house and we want love in this house. Your mother has decided not to speak angry most of the time. But when I get home and she says things to me and upset to me, with me, for me, about me, everything, and then tells me I can't say this to the children and I can't say that to the children and they run and dob on me to you and I'll get in trouble. I said, how can you get in trouble? You're the bloody parent. How can I get you in trouble? I said to her. These kids don't run this house. These kids don't come between us. Demons do. But we're dealing with that. So what do we find out when we talk to each other? What's going on with everybody? Yeah. You do what you're told, and you have a great life. It's one of the commandments. Do what your parents say. Respect your parents. Yeah? And then you know you're right. And if we tell you to do something wrong and you do it, who's going to get flogged?
You guys.
Yeah. Until you're old enough to leave home and get a job. Simple. Do what you're told. Got a pretty good life. Shops across the street, swimming pool in the backyard, cinema screen there with stuff that's actually at the cinema, you know, on it. Pretty much a week later, it's in, we've got it. What else could you want? You got video games on the weekends, and your hoosh is in the house. I don't know anybody else except one other house in Cairns that has Yahushua in their house. Got a bloody good life. Milk it. Have a good time. All you got to do is one job, maybe two a day. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Wonderful. Anybody like to say anything?
I
gave him like 10 garlic and horseradish and everything last night. And then I just had another two. And he's got those. See how you go during the day. It's going to be sunny today.
Is your nose blocked up?
It keeps getting blocked and then it gets running again. And
where's that herb hippie spray thing I gave you for your throat, antiseptic spray?
That's a nasal spray.
Didn't I give that to you?
I can spray that up your nose.
Give it to me, but...
So as you're breathing in, you spray it, lock the other nostrils.
I'm on the right shelf with all the other drugs.
Can you have a look with me?
There's a spray next
to the wall.
Is it? I see you like it. Yeah, it says
that. Is that it? I see a spray. Is that it?
Oh, that's it? Yeah. This thing tastes like poison. But actually, have you got a sore throat?
A little bit.
A little bit?
It works.
Keep that. It works. So he hates it, but he says it works. And that'll, when you spray your mouth, breathe in your nose as well. It's got some, all sorts of stuff, honey and herbs and...
Yeah, that was, that's a spray version of the other
one. Mild tonsillitis, so you haven't got tonsillitis, so it'll be fine.
A mild tonsillitis you could have.
Huh?
It's usually what a sore throat leads to, but...
Right, well, we didn't get to the scriptures today. We've got to get ready to go. I'll get it tomorrow. Or next day.
Well, I'm actually a bit of it in.
Sorry?
I'm actually a bit of it.
You've read a bit of it, have you? Oh.
Wrong.
At least.
No, he's saying he's already read some of that. Well, that's good.
Is that what he was saying, is it? Oh. I didn't understand.
I mean,
drink it fast.
I cut my finger open yesterday.
Oh. Being a fool?
No.
Cleaning the dishes.
How do you cut your finger open cleaning the dishes?
There was a sharp thing back and there was something stuck on it.
The strainer. Bit of the pasta had got stuck under it because he doesn't have nails.
Oh, use your finger open on pasta. Wow.
Nah, on the metal.
That's a story for the war room, isn't it? I cut my finger open on pasta.
Gotta get dressed, please.
Yeah, come on.
You got school. Glass open with the dishwasher.
Stand in the sun as much as you can today.
We have cross country.
There you go. Take your time and just take your time and walk slow in the sun, yeah? Don't push yourself. So I tell you to hurry up, say so I'm sick.
I'll throw a rat test at him.
Mm. And he'll kick me out of the school.
Kick you out of school?
Yeah, he's not going to school if he's sick.
Yeah.
Well, you can walk home then, in the sun.
Yeah. Got your lunchbox?
Morning. What's up, bro?
Got your lunchbox?
Did you want me to ride so I can help set up on this afternoon?
No, we don't have much to set up this afternoon. I'm not using the sound system anymore.
Yeah.
Do you have a laptop?
Yeah, we'll need that. I don't need that till tomorrow night, Ben.
And I'm not here.
You're not taking it with you. Now you're bringing it back here anyway.
I'm not in the mood for an argument. You can talk to your mother about that.
And you'll be leaving me here.
Come here and I'll paint something on your face.
Could I have the green? Because I'm in greenhouse anyway.
You can stand here. You can stand over here. What design do you want?
Get your stuff ready. Push your chairs in.
Oh, look. Have you done all your jobs, Fina? Pina is an expert maker and drawing, so she'll do it for you. Here you go, she'd love it. Sit right there. You can't touch it after she's put it on or it'll smudge.
From here. Yeah, and that'll get on your clothing. Because your arms move on your clothing. Oh, if it's here then. Maybe just down here. Come here. Face to face. I don't know, it's like an average, you know. No, you're not. Mine can use this ink stick. It was green. Instead of green and yellow, it was green and gold. Together, he used the green. Because There's black and white, red, yellow, and blue. Do you want some on your nose? Like a dot on your nose or some down here?
I'm gonna have like three little stripes. I can
have original. But both greens
that are white. Mine's too small.
Like that?
Yeah.
Come on. Out the way, Robert. Move. Get your laptop and stuff.
Mm-hmm. How itchy is smudged it?
It's not smudged at the moment. It's okay. Do you have your lunchbox in there?
Yep. I look like a little sheep missiles. Good night.